Hi, welcome to a tutorial from Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri, presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how we can use breadboard. Either this size breadboard, smaller size like this, or breadboard like this, or maybe a tiny size like this. Let's get started with this. Breadboard is used to do prototyping before you build the circuit like this, which you will start making PCB and then attaching the components that will turn up to this one. But before that, you can test it on a breadboard and program it. Of course, these are different type of chip that you cannot, but you might be able to use these hole through chips that you can do the prototyping and testing it. So we will use breadboard to either learn or do the prototyping. For example, this is a 7-segment display that I was doing the prototyping. I've connected all the wires here on breadboard for tutorial. Many of my videos I've used these breadboards, so some of them I've just kept them like that. And here's an example of prototyping for a 7-segment display with all these wires. Here's an example of using mini breadboard. I have a lot of tutorials related to electricity, electronic, and robotics, including Arduino and sensors, and I've written a lot of codes. Make sure to subscribe to my channel. We have different size of breadboards, and the size refers to number of pins or holes it has that you can insert. This is called 830 breadboard, which means it has 830 holes. This is called 400 breadboard or 400 point breadboard, which has 400 pins. And this is 170 or mini breadboard. So number of holes, if you just count them, you will see that this has 170 pins. In order for me to demonstrate, I'm gonna use this bulb, which is 12 volts, and this is my power supply. And when I connect it, you will see that it will turn on. There is no sound or anything, so I will use this for demonstration. So first let's see the wire being connected. When I connect these two, the light will turn on. So I'm gonna demonstrate it here. On this breadboard, we have line here, blue, and then red or a little pinkish. So this is referring for power supply, so you can connect it. If you pay attention on this side, because the blue is on that side, this line blue is also on the other side, and the red is on this side for positive. What it means is that all these holes on this side, they are all connected together, and this line that we have seen red, all of these are connected or short-circuited together. And this piece, the power bar here, if you look at it from the bottom, I just removed this piece, and you will see that it is one long piece of metal that is connected all together. So here I just removed it, and as you can see, they are all connected in one piece. The same way on this one, it's just a shorter version of this. So I'm gonna demonstrate it here. Now if I connect this in here, and if I connect it to any point, you will see that the light will turn on. What it means is that from this side to the end, they are all connected. And also the same way for a positive. If I connect it to the positive and the other wire is in the negative, you see these two wires are isolated. And if I connect it here, you will see that this is all connected. The same is true for this side. If I connect it, you will see that the bulb is on. And if I connect it to the red one, the bulb is on. And if I connect it between the red and blue, the bulb is not on, meaning that this line is separated or isolated from the other side, from the blue side. So when you do prototyping, you will connect your power supply, negative and positive here, and you have a lot of positive and negative available at any point that you need. For example, if you connect 5 volts, the 5 volts will be available throughout this board. And then here, we have these lines. They're all labeled and also numbered from 1 to 63 here, vertically A, B, C, D, and E. So you can refer to certain points, for example. And here on each line at the bottom, you see one piece of metal connecting them all. And if I remove this piece, if I push it with this pin, and you can see that we can remove it, and this is what it is at the bottom. So when you insert your wire, they just hold your wire like that at the bottom. Look, I can insert it back. We will see that these lines are all connected like that up to here. So these are all connected up to the end, and this side are connected. This side is isolated from the other side. Let me show you. If I connect this on this line, and if I connect it on the same line, you will see that bulb will turn on. But if I connect it to the next one, it will not turn on. You see? And also if I connect it on this side, it will not turn on because these are isolated. And if I bring it, you will see that this is connected, and next line on this side or on this side, they are not connected. So these are all connected. The same is true for this one, except it's shorter, and you can see it is up to 30 points on horizontally, and ABCD up to E is here. Now let's look at the small one. In the small one, these lines are all connected like that. Nothing is connected like that, but this, the middle, they are isolated. So these lines on one side and these line on this side, and this allows you to insert an IC like that. You see this IC, you can insert it, and it has enough space for IC. And the same is true for this. Let me connect a wire here so you can see it. And now if I wire here, you will see the bulb will turn on. And if I connect it to the next line, the bulb is not turning on, and to the other one as well. And if I connect it on this side, the bulb is not turning on because this line is separating them. But if I bring this on this side, the bulb will turn on. It is now true for this one, except they've connected multiple of these breadboards. If you have a larger project and attach these together, for example, this can be attached to the next one, and you can make a larger breadboard as much as you want. Also, the breadboard is sort like this, with three breadboards attached together on a piece of metal, and we have some terminals so you can connect your power. For example, you see I've connected my positive and negative, and positive I mean connected here. So I have here all positive, and negative will be connected in here with this 4mm banana connector. And these are exactly the same as the other breadboard. At the bottom of the breadboard we have adhesive, and also it has double-sided, and it has tape with glue in case if you want to attach it to something permanently, you can remove this and attach it. But beside that, also you can remove this piece here in case if you want to, if you don't need this, you can remove it. Multiple of this, and you don't need the power line, you can remove this easily like that. So here I've removed this piece from this, and now still you will have those connecting points where you can connect it if you, and you can remove this one as well and connect them together. The same way here now, as you can see between these two, we have only one piece of positive and negative, because this had its own positive negative and this one, but they removed one of them and you have here something like this. And if you look from this side, you will see that we have only one of this piece here, not two for each breadboard. So and here, if you want to, for example, connect these three resistors in series, you do it like that. Just bend the resistors at a certain point, insert it somewhere, doesn't matter as long as you insert it like that, because I mentioned that these are all connected, so these are all isolated from each other, so the other point is here, and I'm connecting another resistor at this point. As you can see, these two are on the same line, so these are in series. And here I've connected now three resistors in series. To connect three resistors in parallel, you will insert one at any point that you want, and then insert the second one on the next hole beside it. And here I've connected all these three resistors in parallel. They're all together on this side on the same row, and here they're connected to the same row. Thank you for watching. This was how to use breadboard. If you found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe,
which I can insert them back.